Today we have Nong Shim Shin Kimchi. Okay, I have had a horrifying amount of the classic Shin Ramyun in my lifetime. I don't even think it would be possible to calculate how many packets of that noodle I have had. But I've never had this Shin Kimchi one. I do love kimchi by itself, but I have to be honest, and possibly controversially, I've just never been a fan of kimchi noodles. I am willing to have my mind blown by this one. This one may be the one that changes my mind, but until now, I've never had a kimchi noodle that has made me think, oh my goodness, that's amazing, I would eat it every day. I know that's possibly controversial because people love this noodle and they do love kimchi noodles in general. There's just so many on the shelf. People do love them. So it's possibly just a personal preference thing. But like I say, I'm willing to have my eyes opened with this and I'm willing to be impressed. Okay, let's have a look at the packaging. Oh, I should probably say this cost £1.10, which is the standard price for Shin Ramyun. So it's, you know, pretty cheap in the grand scheme of things, but my expectations are set at Nong Shim's very high standards. So I'm hoping that this will continue those high standards as well. Okay, in terms of the packaging then, I like it. I love the color scheme. I think it's great. Not sure about the typography, but I do really quite like this. I think it's really eye-catching in terms of the color. Honestly, if they just changed the writing of that, it would be pretty much perfect, I have to say. It's clearly vegan, which is a selling point. Okay, I don't think there's anything else on the front. And on the back, I don't think there's anything too controversial here. Cooking instructions, add noodles and contents of the sachets into 500 mils of boiling water, cook for 4 minutes, stir well and serve. The reason I have to read this is for this channel, I always cook to the recipe, the cooking instructions. I could make Shin Ramyun with my eyes closed, but I don't think I've done it to the recipe in possibly 10 years. So just knowing what the recipe is important for this. So in terms of the ingredients then, we've got noodles, which just look fairly standard in terms of wheat and potato starch. Seasoning powder. This is where usually the magic happens. But I have to say, the only sort of real flavors I'm seeing here are mustard oil, you know, all sorts of E numbers and random spices, garlic, black pepper. It's really hard to get a sense of the flavors just from reading the ingredients list on this. So you really have to just see what it tastes like. The vegetable flakes though, I'm really excited for. Kimchi Chinese cabbage flakes with Chinese cabbage, garlic, red chili pepper, pak choi, carrot and green onion. Nong Shim have had some really amazing flake packets, which you'll have seen on some of my other videos. So I'm quite looking forward to seeing what they're like. Of high expectations for that, but other than that, I think it's fairly standard for Nong Shim. Quality of packaging is really excellent, as always. It feels really high quality, so you know, pretty much par for the course for Nong Shim. Right, let's go inside. Okay, there we go. The classic Nong Shim noodles that everyone will have had a million of from Shin Ramyun. Wow. Love the color scheme on that. Love the branding on these. A lot of crushed noodles in there, which I'll just leave to the side. Let's have a look at these. Nong Shim noodles are generally pretty excellent. I really, really do enjoy them. I love the color of them as well. They're always yellower than other brands, which I really like. Let's save the flakes for afterwards. We'll do the soup base next. Okay, as soon as I poured that, I just get hit with the smell of chili. Mmm. There's so much going on there. Peppery, garlicky, oniony, really, really intense smell off that. Okay, and these flakes. Still love color scheme on that. That is unbelievable. Okay, this did not disappoint. Those flakes just look unreal. The quality. I don't know if you can see that. Quality is excellent on those Nong Shim ones, and to the point where I actually look forward to these on a lot of Nong Shim noodles when I get to the end of the bowl. So I'm really excited for that. So that's it. That's everything out of this packet of noodles. Very standard for a Nong Shim noodle. I think we're ready to cook it up. Okay. That looks and smells amazing. My mouth is watering. It looks just like Shin Ramyun, if I'm honest. Let's have a smell and see. Okay, There is something that isn't quite the same as normal shin ramyun. I mean, I wouldn't say it smells extremely different. Right, but there's something a little bit ketchup-y on the nose. You know, that sort of slightly vinegary, sweet ketchup smell. I'm getting a little bit of that, so I'm guessing this is going to be slightly sourer because it's kimchi. Yeah, it smells a little bit tomatoey. You know, a little bit tomatoey, a little bit vinegary. Definitely the usual kind of oniony, chili flavors on the nose. Yeah, there's definitely that sort of tomato ketchup-y sweetness on the aroma. Let's have a look at these noodles. Those are the noodles that we've come to know and love. Nice and thick and bouncy. You know, they look really, really appetizing. Okay, let's start by tasting the broth. Okay, definitely very tangy. Mouth is watering, but not from the usual chili. It's from some sort of sourness. Mmm, wow, it is actually really nice. Mmm, wow. Okay, so salty, chilly, savory, definitely tart, but also sweet. I mean, I wouldn't say if I was doing a blind tasting, I wouldn't guess that this was kimchi flavor, but I can definitely get that sense, that reminiscence of kimchi. It actually tastes a little bit milder than the normal shin ramyun as well. Like, I think usually my mouth would be completely on fire. My mouth isn't completely burning. I do think it is milder than the standard shin ramyun, but just look at those noodles. I think that's what we're all here for. Right, let's give it a go. Okay, definitely getting that lovely mouthfeel, the lovely texture that you expect with shin ramyun. It is brilliant, and it's one of the reasons why I've had shin ramyun so many times, is that texture. But honestly, the main thought going into my head when I was eating that was tomato ketchup flavor. Let me have another bite and see what I think. Yeah. That one wasn't reminiscent of tomato ketchup. Definite sweetness that you don't get on the normal shin ramyun, and it's definitely more sour. Definitely not as spicy. Definitely still nice and savory and salty. I think the sugar, or sort of the sweetness, just really enhances it a little bit, I have to say. It really is surprisingly nice. Yeah, I'm actually pleasantly surprised by this. My nose is starting to run. This is the bit of the bowl where usually the flakes start to sort of change the taste slightly. Mmm. Okay, that actually tasted of onion. See if there are any other interesting flakes in here. Right, that's definitely a bit of cabbage. Mmm, it is actually quite nice. Nice and sweet, nice and crunchy. Definitely has a different flavor than what I'm used to. That tomato ketchup-y sort of reminiscence is coming back. Okay. All right. That was quite nice. I have to say, my expectations were in some ways high because Nong Shim, you know, and Shin Ramyun is amazing as a noodle. But also my expectations were quite low in some regards because I just usually don't really go for kimchi noodles. I have to have a little think about whether this is something that I would get again. It was nice, don't get me wrong. This was a really tasty noodle, great soup, great noodle texture, really, really high quality. And if this was the only noodle option available from Nong Shim, I would probably be saying different things right now. But I have to think, is this as good as Shin Ramyun, the classic one? Is it anywhere near as good? Does it add anything having this kimchi version? Is this something I'm ever gonna reach for again? And I have to say, if I was to sum up the taste of that for me, it was like making shin ramyun with half of the soup base packet, but with a load of ketchup added in, if I had to try and recreate that. And to me, that's just not enough to make me want to purchase this again. And it also makes me think, would I miss this if it wasn't on the shelf? And I have to say, I kind of wouldn't really miss it. I have to say, I feel like I would be able to recreate that flavor. I could see myself reaching for the soon or the chapageti or the shin ramyun time and time again, even the shin red add something. But you know, does this really add anything having it there on the shelf? I don't really think this adds to the flavor in a unique, meaningful, or memorable way, I have to be honest. So if you had £1.10 to spend on a noodle, I wouldn't recommend it was this one. I think there are so many other better options out there, especially even from Nong Shim. You've got Shin Ramyun, you've got Chapageti, you've got Shin Red, you've got Soon. So I just don't think I could recommend this one if you're going to spend that amount of money. So for me, all in all, This was a good noodle. I liked it, but I don't think it was memorable enough. And I'm not sure kimchi really adds anything in this instance. So for me, this is a heartbreaking 2.5 out of 5, which I appreciate is going to be quite controversial. I know there's a lot of love out there for this noodle, but let me know if you agree or if you disagree, and I'll see you next time.